Hello, we are now looking at an e-commerce website that is designed by WordPress with WooCommerce. And in the previous video, I have shown how to create a shop or page consisting of different parent category headings and the list of products under that particular category. So we have the bedding category, and then when you scroll down, you see the home decor category with the product listing. You see the settings category with the product listing as well as the storage category. Okay, this should come with the product listing too. All right, let's see. Okay, oh, this is a page two, so page one. Okay, so the storage one comes with the product listing here as well. Now the problem when we do such a product listing with categories, different categories, is that when we insert our products in one row for ease of browsing, we end up with a pagination function here. And when we click on page two, this does not just apply for the bedding. The page two applies then for the rest of the categories. And it can be a little bit confusing, especially under storage here, where we only have four products and we do not really have products in page two, right? So this is not very user-friendly, okay? Such a template is not very user-friendly. So today we are going to work around removing this pagination tab and making browsing more friendly, helping your audience to browse better, but still have such a page that will look quite good as well. So let's get down to a little bit of editing at the back end. I'm going to pages, and then I'm going to shop or, all right, it's a shop or page that we are working on. Edit with Elementor. So it seems like first the product listing wasn't set to full width mode. So let's just maybe set them to full width over here. Edit section. All right. We shall do the same for the rest, okay, of the product listing very quickly. Okay, so storage, we will set it to full width as well. Okay, now we need to also solve the problem of this pagination. So let's see. So we'll have one row still to make browsing easier, more friendly, but we're going to off the pagination. Okay, so we're just going to see four products. Maybe the product images are quite big, so we may want to even increase the number of columns to 5 or to 6. Okay, and over here as well, maybe we can have 6 images for settings as well. We can have 6, but for storage, we only have 4 products under storage, so we can just keep it as 4 here. All right, so the rest of them we have more products here. Now, the problem now will be your audience will not know that you actually have more products under bidding, right? So how do we go about it? We can create a button, okay, or another section, right? Say for example, we can create additional row for section, okay, here, a section. And then we insert a button into this section. Centralize it, all right, keep it. Okay, and then we can browse more. All right, we can do a browse more. And then we shall then insert the link for this category page into this browse more. So they know, okay, I have, these are some of the products under bidding. And if I click on browse more, I can actually find more products under bidding. Okay, so this would be one way to go about it. Now, another way that we can go about this is actually to create a section, all right, that has two columns, all right, two columns, but we shall just downsize the column at the right, and then we can move this browse more button into this right side, okay, into this right hand side. Yep, so browse more is here, and then this entire piece goes into the left side. Now, browse more looks a little bit weird over there. So we may want to set some margin. Okay, let's see whether we may position it in the middle. We can't, so we'll have to set a top margin for browse more. We can centralize this thing. Or another way would be, instead of using a button, we may want to just use a heading. Okay, you can just use a heading, and that says browse more. Browse more. Okay, and then we do centralize it. And then for margin again, we may just move it downwards a little bit more. Okay, you can move it down a little bit more. We may want to add for this column, okay. Vertical alignment, let's see, middle. Okay, so if we fix it to middle, and then we can just remove the margin here. Okay, so that works. So for the column style, we can just set a background color so that in a way it stands out. Maybe we can add a color that is closer to the buttons that we set it. Okay, so maybe a color that is a bit closer. Okay, maybe something like that. All right, and then for border, we may want to also round it a little bit. Okay, round the border. Okay, so hover. We can then have a box shadow upon hover. Okay, so let's just view the responsive mode, how it's going to look like over here on the desktop. Okay, something like that. So we can do that. Okay, we can create a browse more option. And then with that, we get rid of the pagination function, and still your audience will be able to browse more in the category page for bidding. So that is all I want to talk about for this video. Hope it helps. Thank you for watching.